the floor general for Indiana. Heading back to the Fever after spending some time with them, was an all-star in her tenure, and NaLyssa Smith on the board first. Cheyenne Parker going against Aaliyah Boston. Tough bucket.
I like the mindset. Ryan not settling for the three, looking to be aggressive and get to the bucket. And you know, the mid-range is money.
Amy McDonald using her speed, working the baseline. Gray outside, bottom of the net.
Excited to see what Kelsey Mitchell will do this season for Indiana. Should have been an all-star in this league probably on a couple of occasions, and I know that's something that's important to her.
Also a consecutive record in the WNBA. Missed the last five games due to a plantar partial tear. As the three ball is working for Atlanta early.
Balance with the three-point shot. It really just opens up things.
Kelsey Mitchell, as you alluded to, could definitely knock that down. Misses the mark, finds the hands of Alicia Gray. Gray using the speed, nice kiss off the glass. The left side is where she thrives. Not just out of rookies, but was fifth in the WNBA in blocks per game and second as far as rebounds, as far as rookies. Ryan Howard gets the long two.
Every time Monique Billings touches the floor, Atlanta are going to get extra possessions.
But they do not have much time to recover. Kelsey Mitchell to get her shot off.
Just plays the game at a whole nother pace. Like, there is no one on the floor playing with the speed that she is playing with. And how about two jumpers to go?
Play the game at a pace in which Tanisha Wright was saying she has put in the work. We trust her in that shot and showing everyone in the building today. Christy Wallace, 8 on the shot clock, pulls up for 3 and knocks it down.
Sure, a lot of those fans are Gamecocks here in the Southeast. Maybe some Kentucky fans too sprinkled in here to see Ryan.
Erica Wheeler for the triple. Gray puts on the Jets, gets it to go. Boston going at Cheyenne Parker. That's a professional move.
That's a tough move.
Kentucky went on a tear to get that title as NaLyssa Smith is able to finish underneath.
Smith is so talented. You pop Cheyenne Parker off of the paint, take her away from that, some of that physicality, and that shows her versatility with the face-up game.
Yeah, LaChina following a 25-point first quarter. 50% from the three-point line, now 2 for 6. Smith rises up, and that 6-4 frame is tough to go. Mitchell coming off the screen finds Smith.
So skilled. Silky smooth.
Now demanding the ball on the inside, Nia Coffey couldn't find the right angle. Howard going at hole, draws a foul.
That was Grace Berger on the foul.
Misses the and-one opportunity, but how this about this one? Cheyenne Parker, what can't you do? Egbo, rebound, rims around and finally finds the bottom. At the next dead ball, Nas Hillman will be checking in. Queen Egbo with a tough turnaround. And McDonald looking for some help with 5 on the shot clock. Corner 3 by Ryan Howard finds the bottom of the net. Gets the and one, and that shot will be reviewed. Holding on to this 43-38 lead over Indiana. Cheyenne Parker, my goodness, with the left.
Parker has already been to the free throw line 7 times in this game. Physical.
Christy Wallace raising over Durr
on her retirement into the Atlanta Dream for making an excellent hire.
Absolutely. Ryan Howard trying to see if she can get something against Smith. Does after the third spin around, so she's now at 12. She serves as the player's primary off-court liaison, just making sure that everything as far as their transition into the league is done seamlessly. Erica Wheeler at the top of the key. You mentioned her getting into a rhythm.
Just a beautiful isolation set up offensively for her to take advantage of the defense, and she's done that all afternoon.
Ryan Howard knocks down the triple. great defense that we're seeing from Atlanta. NaLyssa Smith with three on the shot clock, finds the bottom of the bucket and gives the crowd a yell.
I know for sure, but yes. Great to see Swin, Naismith Hall of Famer. I think she played with Tanisha Wright both in New York and Seattle.
Great defense as they set up.
Yes, good defensive transition by Nas, but baseline drive by another familiar name on this roster for Indiana, Maya Caldwell.
10-day contracts with Atlanta. She started all but two games, so had nine starts with Atlanta as Alicia Gray is able to finish at the rim.
Well, she knew the identity she wanted to bring to Indiana. Very defensive-minded, very tough, and a lot of those players were already playing in that role here for the Dream. On the floor, rookie playing PG up against some pressure from the Fever.
Five to work with. Gray about 4 feet beyond the three, set, no doubt, knocks it down.
Four assists, three rebounds, doing a little bit of everything.
Mind you, coming off of her ninth double-double in her career. Going at NaLyssa Smith, couldn't find the footing as we're less than a minute to play in the third. Gets it back, and that one works.
That is how you repost. Lots of deflections for Atlanta right now in this possession.
Kelsey Mitchell with some magic work underneath. 4 second difference between shot and game clock. Cheyenne Parker didn't like the look against Boston. Sends it to Ryan Howard. You bet. Christy Wallace comes down with it.
Atlanta has gotten some looks strong side on some drives and just weren't able to find the angle. But I'm telling you, who can find the angle?
Wallace dealt with a lot of injury to get back on the floor in the WNBA as that's denied underneath. Cheyenne Parker bit on the up and under, and Queen Egbo adds the deuce. Mary McDonald enters the chat with a triple of her own.
What an honor and well-deserving for Ryan, who we expect to be an absolute superstar in this league.
Three on the shot clock. Smith, the distance, can get it and does. My. Doing everything she can to pick up a win for Indiana. Queen Egbo, fadeaway, drains it.
And taking advantage of Atlanta in an area where they don't have a lot of depth in their bigs.
And as Cheyenne Parker responds with an and one of her own, drains it. 17 lean change. This has gone back and forth. And the and one for Grace Berger.
How about the rookie on the road?
Ryan Howard seeing two players running at her at this point. Gray gets one too. Gets the flyby in the triple. One with Asia Wilson. 2017, Victoria Vivian's for the triple, my goodness. We got ourselves a ball game.
And you can't fault Gray for shooting the three, but we just heard Tabitha say, Tanisha Wright said she wanted everything at the rim, and a pull-up by Erica Wheeler showing why she is a winner.
Trying to find Ryan Howard does at the top of the key. Ryan Howard flips it up, and I don't know how it went down, but it does for the reigning rookie of the year.
Has got to get back and get set.
Smith turns down the three, couple dribbles, floater remains hot. Ryan Howard with three left, raises up, misses everything, finds the hands of Aaliyah Boston, and the streak is over for the Indiana Fever.